Oh! Yo!
Jess Dustin has booked us a little something special. Big thank you to Wondrium for sponsoring this video. Hey guys, I'm the Hacksmith. This is Jess Dustin. You might remember him from his Unbreakable Box series. Most recently, we broke into your Unbreakable Orb, a D20 die, and I gotta say, it was quite a bit more of a challenge than the original Unbreakable Box. But we had to one-up you, so we've built something even bigger. Hey, Ian!
It's a little bit bigger than the one I gave
you.
It
weighs about 150 pounds.
Uh-huh.
100 of that is polycarb.
Uh-huh.
Another 50 pounds of steel. This baby's got Wi-Fi, it's got RGB LEDs, uh-huh. And it's got your original $1,000 inside.
Hold on, wait, did you say Wi-Fi? The $1,000, first of all, I'm happy you're giving
it's
that
back. It's an unbreakable Tesseract uh-huh. with Wi-Fi.
That's pretty amazing. Let me just say mine weighed about 30 pounds. This is 150, so.
I wanna see Trent pick this one up.
Yeah, some call that cheating, some call it trying. We're here, I'm gonna break into it.
Let's do it. So we thought it'd be cool to show you how we actually made the box.
Very curious.
As we're breaking it.
Yeah.
And to be honest, I haven't actually seen this cut yet either, because I actually had nothing to do with this project.
Yeah.
Henry took lead and he built this amazing box for you, and we'll see if you can break into it.
Henry helped break my box, so I feel like it's a little bit of revenge building. We'll
see. I think he mentions that a few times.
Does he? Yeah. Of course he does. Yeah, we'll see.
Let's check it out.
Priorities to make the box unbreakable, but I also want it to be unlike anything we've seen before.
Up we go.
Let's see what we can design with this.
All right, ready?
That's like early stages of what I was doing, just testing just a piece of Lexan by itself.
Yeah.
Unbreakable box version like 0.1. It was just wood with a Lexan front. That's it.
Promised him we were building one of our own. That's all finished now. Let me show you how we made it.
Fun fact, this laser just broke.
Really?
Yeah.
Building the box?
Or on something else? Something else.
Okay, all right.
Or this might have been its last legs, actually.
Really?
We gotta figure out, like, it's the fiber optic coupler or something,
mm-hmm.
and it, like, melted.
Yeah, buy some merch. That machine's expensive.
Hacksmith.store. So what he's doing right now is he's actually making the internal frame, which holds all the pieces in place.
Okay. So he did this entirely solo?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, this is a pure co-op project.
Wow. That's awesome.
As you can see, I have 2 half-inch sheets of polycarbonate, which I've glued together with some acrylic cement. And the reason I did this is because 1-inch polycarbonate in the size I need is about $13,000 a sheet. So if I do it this way,
Wait, hold on.
So we're gonna
I'm rewinding.
Did you say $13,000 a sheet?
1-inch polycarbonate in the size I need is about $13,000
yeah.
a sheet.
Yeah,
so
it's
I need to check my bank account balance.
That's
I have no idea what the budget
it's
on this
about,
was.
It's about $1,000 a sheet for it's about $1,000 a sheet for the half inch. But if you go up for that, it has to be custom. Because they don't just carry it on hand. And that's the contact cement up there, the little bottle.
Oh, yeah.
It's like plastic welding. It fuses the Lexan together.
Ooh, that looks awesome.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Yeah, look, this is the inner cube.
I honestly think this is really maybe bold. The inner cube will be exponentially harder than the outer cube.
That's so thick. Like, look at the...
Yeah.
There's not going to be any flex on it.
Yeah, that's
and you're not going to crack it easily, if at all. Getting nervous?
A little, honestly, yeah, a little bit. Like the inner cube, because I like the outer one, like I know it's going to be hard, but I think it's doable. The inner one, I've never done anything like that before. No way. This is just, it's too dense. This is like so intense. I literally, if I was going to put LEDs, I would have taped it or glued the LEDs into the box.
The inner cube is done. But as you
look at that.
All those pieces. Look at that.
Imagine
asking a machine shop to build this for you and how much they would quote.
Maybe
like 20 grand or something.
Yeah, for sure. Easily. Okay, this is what I want to see. Yeah, the pyramid sort of thing going on here to hold it.
Yeah, so to be honest, like I think that's only 1/4-inch polycarb, so that's like probably the weakest polycarb of the system.
But it's about like it just
the angles
holding
and,
it.
Yeah.
And just dispersing impact. Like Lexan's really good at dispersing impact because it flexes. That's just adding to it, right? Because it's like, it's just gonna, yeah. I don't know, in theory.
I realized the best next move is to weld the bottom of these bolts to the actual support. The reason I'm doing that is because otherwise, it's just kind of gonna rotate and the bottom bolt is gonna rotate with the nut when I try to tighten it, which doesn't work.
I think he found that out from the last orb, because he was breaking into it.
Yeah.
And he was saying, oh, one of the bolts is loosening, because we tack welded them. But I think somehow when you hit it, it broke the tack.
Yeah.
And one of the things got loose that way.
Yeah, that's why you can't use a wrench to break into an unbreakable box. We weld the box shut.
Exactly. And the first one we did. First one you could have just took the bolts out. Yeah. But that was like the only rule we said. But yeah, the other ones you can't do that.
Look how cool that looks there.
That looks great. Yeah, like if I wanted to just like dissect this like with tools, I don't think I could.
Yeah, look. Yeah. Oh, good work, Henry.
That's pretty beautiful. I'm not going to lie. I think the mirrored tint really helps it in the look.
Oh, yeah.
When under the light, because then
it's like an Infinity Cube.
It's like an Infinity Cube.
Which is a pun there, because it's Tesseract.
Yeah, there you go. Yes.
Our Tesseract is an Infinity Cube based on an Infinity Stone.
Yes. I got a plan.
Yeah.
I got a plan. I can't tell you yet, but I definitely got a plan.
Well, let's see what happens.
Yeah. Oh, that's it.
That was it. We're ready to go.
This is where I come in. And I got a plan now. Watch this.
Part of the reason I started Hacksmith Industries was to inspire people to learn. I love to learn. We strive to add teachable moments to every single one of our episodes so that aside from the entertainment value, you also learn something new every time you watch. But the learning doesn't have to stop there. Wondrium is where you can find answers to everything you ever wondered about. Just like our videos, Wondrium encourages learning through entertainment. They cover an insane amount of topics, short and long form videos, tutorials, how-tos, travel logs, documentaries, and more, all presented by engaging experts.
Robots with legs offer some of the most extreme challenges in all of robotics.
I've been checking out their series on robotics and loving it. Learning about Tridino, the Guinness World Record holder for the largest four-legged walking robot, has been pretty mind-blowing. It weighs in at 22,000 pounds, but who knows, maybe one day Hacksmith Industries can challenge that record. So if you've ever wondered about anything and would love to learn more, Wondrium is your new favorite place. Check it out at wondrium.com/thehacksmith and claim your free trial today.
Everything under the shell pretty much is welded. But here's the thing. It's like at the end of the day, your weld's only as strong as your steel is thick.
Exactly.
And this isn't that thick.
Once we get this off, there's the tubing underneath that we have to get.
Yeah, but the tubing, like Trent with a sledge will make short work of tubing. It's the only thing is we're progressing to that, right? And I want to do more damage before that. So if we can pry this, and it's mostly going to be like strategic hits.
Right.
You know what I mean? In the corner. And then once we get that open, literally the hardest thing is the inner cube. Like without like leverage and stuff, like there's just no way. I think they're overestimating the strength of the weld a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, it's thin metal. The Hacksmith just delivered what he calls a Tesseract. Supposedly it's unbreakable.
That's right. This is the latest and greatest from Hacksmith Industries. It's made of 100 pounds of polycarb and over 50 pounds of steel. If you can crack through the outer layer, there's actually an inner cube that is also made of 1-inch polycarb, and there's a special surprise in there. Also, did I mention it has Wi-Fi?
It has Wi-Fi, nice. Well, we have a Trent. How long did it take for you to break into our box?
It was about 5 hours.
5 hours. We're gonna break into this box in 4 hours and 59 minutes. Just make it a little bit of a friendly competition.
All right. All right. Yeah, I feel safer behind you.
Fight! We have a general rule on this channel where Zach's not allowed to throw things, but for this video, we could use, we need him to throw
Here
things.
Here I am.
I'm ready to throw.
This is not our camera. This is a challenge I just can't miss out on. It kind of did. Maybe just give it to Trent. This bat is breakable. But this one is not. Here we go. This is a big boy bat. We got the Brooklyn Basher.
Ooh.
Ah!
Ooh, and that's what happens when you hit an unmovable object with an unbreakable bat.
That's, I understand. Yeah, that's, throw it? Yeah, I do, please, yes.
There we go.
Nice weapon. We don't need Zach to throw it. Oh, look at that. Found a weak point. Let's put this in the unsafe category. When in doubt, Trent, you go with the hammer. Trent, take a deep breath. You know, sometimes it's not about the brawn, it's about the brains. You got the sharp part. Here we go. Oh. Leverage, science, engineering.
So I hate to break it to you, but all the metal you see is actually strictly decorative.
What?
So I gotta be honest, you remember Thanos copter, right? What's scarier, Thanos copter or this?
This is way more dangerous than Thanos copter.
This is terrifying.
Excuse me, paging Mr. James. Low fear? Yeah, a little bit of fear. Let's keep going.
I'm impressed the light system on.
Same, to be honest.
They started doing some rainbow thing when you really got going. It's pretty good, actually.
Solid. Trading the hammer in for a pickaxe. Well, a mini pickaxe. Oh!
I'm not into it, man.
Let's just fling pieces of Lexan everywhere. I'm not going to lie. I was kind of happy about it. Because everyone's all right.
Even once we're through that one layer, they have to hit the small cube, which is like inside and just awkward to hit. Like they wouldn't even be able to hit it with the little pickaxes because it's too deep inside.
Oh! That's...
Oh my god, that's a hazard.
He doesn't value aesthetic damage. We on this channel do.
I love how he's inside the curtain now. So I feel like Henry didn't actually watch all of Just Dustin's videos, because I think he thought this cube was unbreakable to Just Dustin, but he forgot they have a Trent. And yeah.
Yeah!
That's the inner Tesseract. So this is another two layers of half-inch polycarb, this time glued together with the welded frame. It being small is actually going to make it really challenging, I think. So,
do we have a plan for that? Just so happens we do. Do any of you guys have a plan? I figured somebody else other than me would.
You hear that?
Just Dustin has booked us a little something special to try and destroy the inner cube of our Tesseract. So if you guys want to see the box drop from the helicopter, make sure you check out Just Dustin's video. It's linked below in the end card. It's going to be awesome. Hey, Henry, it's the Hacksmith. So we just got back from Just Dustin's, and they threw your unbreakable box out of a helicopter.
What?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah, so you're gonna have to check out the video on Just Dustin's channel to see if it survived.
Okay, that's insane.
And your co-op grade depends on it.
Okay, you can give me a hint if it survived or not?
Nope.
Okay, that'd be fun.
All right, have a good one.
Bye.
Bye.
So there you go.
Sweet.
Perfect.